This is an old circular saw that I have from many, many years ago. Probably was a $30 saw, real cheap. And I never used it for anything important. It was just a demolition saw, and I used it for cutting fiber cement backer board. So it's a saw that's outlived its usefulness now because the bearings are shot, and I'm just going to throw it out and replace it with another cheapo model. But I wanted to show you, while I'm in the process of doing that, one of the things I do when I'm throwing out a tool or it's broken and not fixable is to save some of the parts that might be useful for a different saw. For example, this power cord is actually in pretty good shape, and that's something that I often have difficulty with on other tools, is that I'll cut through a power cord sometimes, or recently I had a reciprocating saw that I put down and the blade was hot and it burned right through the rubber. So this is something that I'll save because I might be able to use it on a different tool in the future. And so I thought I'd just open this saw up to show you what it looks like. We may get a chance, I haven't even opened this up yet, but we may get a chance to look at the brushes on the motor. They may be replaceable, and that's something we can check as well. So I'm going to start taking this tool apart, and I'll show you on video what we're looking at. All right, first thing I want to do is just retrieve this power cord. I've taken a few things off the saw, actually, before I started, like these, this nut and bolt holding the blade on. I'll probably save because they're kind of a universal part I can use in some other saws probably. There was a wing nut that I'll save that just held the shoe adjustment in place. And I've used just a Phillips screwdriver to remove these plastics or the screws in this plastic handle. Usually it's either Phillips or Torx. In this case it was Phillips on the handle. So now I'm ready to pry this apart and we'll see what we see inside. All right, so this is very typical of what you see. Here's the trigger here, which actually, I might save the trigger for the hell of it. So that is wired to the power cord, which I'll save. And then you got two wires that go into the motor itself. So this is all, it just comes right out. And this is very typical of what you see inside a lot of handles for saws and drills and other things. So what I'm gonna do is I'll probably take this motor apart, but what I would normally do is just clip the wires here and then just save this for later. Sometimes I'll just use the power cord and I can clip the wires here and put new connectors on it and use it for a different trigger and a different power tool. But in this case, I'm going to take the motor apart anyway just to show you what's in there. So I'll probably just save this all together. So I'm going to get to the motor part now here. This part has Torx screws, so I'll do that off camera just not to waste your time, but I'll take that apart and then we'll pull this housing off. All right, first thing I did was take a screw out here and here, and I had a sneaky suspicion the brushes would be under here. And I'm not gonna go into a whole explanation of how motors work, but most, not all, but a lot, most power tools use brushes to distribute the power, and some of them are replaceable, some of them are not. I may have to take this whole thing apart to get at these, but let me see if I can get this out. There. So in this case, these brushes are replaceable. So if this was an expensive saw, I might actually take this step. It's a throwaway saw, so I don't care. But the way this one works is it has a metal connector here, brass, which so this wire that you saw earlier eventually gets to this little connector here. And then these carbon brushes, they're spring-loaded. I don't know if you can see that spring or not, but there's a spring right in there. And they're spring-loaded, and they push against the armature of the motor itself. And these carbon brushes are what distributes the electrical power to the motor, or through the motor, I should say. So these are replaceable. This is actually in pretty good shape, and probably the other one will be too. But if this was a saw there that you wanted to repair and save, you could replace these brushes. I probably won't save these because they're proprietary to this particular saw, but that gives you some idea what it's like to replace the brushes if it were a more expensive saw and it was worth the effort. I've taken out the screws that held the housing together. Let's see what we got here. Actually, this little piece here is a brass. It's not really a bearing, it's a bushing, which held one end of the armature in there. And let's see if I can get this thing apart. There. So there, hopefully you can see this on camera. I mean, there's half of the motor right there, and you see the wires going in there. which lead up to where the brushes are. So I'll just clip those wires because I'm just going to save this cord. I just want to show you what it looked like inside. And then the armature is here, which actually is in pretty decent shape, I have to say. What was giving me trouble were these bushings. They're not bearings, they're bushings. And probably some of the gearing in there is just beat up too. So it just isn't worth it for $30 for me to mess with this, but at least you get an idea of what's inside. And the brushes were riding against this copper plated area right here. All right, so that's what distributes the electrical power. And then the gearing of the saw is, it's like a little transmission right here. I could probably take this apart further, but it just isn't worth it. So if I was trying to save this saw, I might try to take it apart, lubricate these bushings, lubricate the transmission if I could get that apart and that kind of thing. But like I said, it just isn't worth it. But if you're going to throw a saw out like this, or any other power tool for that matter, it's definitely worth saving the electrical cord, because you can use that somewhere else. And some of these little parts you may use, you know, like some of the wing nuts, and even these little screws are hard to find. So I'll save a bunch of that stuff and throw out the rest.